So, we have just been visited by the great white chief from across the water. Yes, I just look how the press presents it. There you are. Can you see that? This is today's Metro. Trump, I snubbed Corbyn. Really, I thought it was Corbyn that snubbed Trump by refusing to go to this jamboree with the Queen and all the other high dignitaries. Invited to a wonderful dinner. Here we are, look, this page nine. Look at that. The president's menu. Well, I don't know what exactly they had to eat. I do know that the taxpayer would have paid quite a lot of money for that meal. I do, however, know, because it's in the paper, the same issue, tucked away on page five. The main item on the agenda, here it is. Can you read that? The NHS is on the table. That's the tastiest dish of all, of course. Better than all the truffles and whatever else they might be scoffing. The NHS. Of course, Donald Trump, among his other many well-known virtues, is, of course, an experienced salesperson. Yes, he sells things. And when he landed in Britain, of course, on Monday, he was here to sell certain things to the British government and the British people. What items was Mr. Trump selling us? He was trying to sell us rats shit, chlorinated chicken, and last but not least, Boris the Barbarian, Boris Johnson. He was trying to sell us these things. You know, it reminds me of a poster that they used to produce when Richard Nixon was president of the United States. The Democrats put on a huge poster, "Would you let this man sell you a second-hand car?" Good question. Now, of course, what is interesting, I've made the point before, but you will excuse me for repeating myself. To all those people, doubtless well-meaning, honest, sincere people, sincere patriots, who tell us, you must support Brexit because we want to get control of our nation back, our national sovereignty. All that you have to do is to free yourself, to use Trump's expression, Britain must free itself from the shackles which bind us to the European Union. And then all our problems will be solved as if by magic. Now, you also will probably know, because I've told you, that I am not a great admirer of the European Union. It is a reactionary capitalist outfit which is not in the interests of the working class, as the Remainers tried to tell us. Ask the Greeks, ask the people of Greece, what the meaning of Brussels and Berlin is. They will tell you soon enough. Yes, that's okay, I accept all that. Don't argue about that. But the argument that somehow, by breaking with this capitalist club, and ploughing our own furrow in the world, that Britain is going to become great again, and we're going to get our sovereignty back, this is entirely false. You see, what was the real meaning of Donald Trump's visit? What was the man after? Among other things else, we know that he's interested in real estate. And he acted throughout his visit, you know, with completely his usual arrogant manner. He acted exactly like a viceroy, an imperial viceroy, coming to investigate his colony. Oh yes, he's eyeing the real estate. He's got his eye on Britain as a choice piece of real estate for the United States to take over lock, stock and barrel. That's why the paper says correctly, the NHS is on the table. Don't you understand? Don't you understand that all these Brexiteers, but just look at the gang, just look at them. Boris Johnson, Rees-Mogg, all the other gang. Members of the ruling class, aristocrats, rich boys, exploiters, okay, enemies of the working class. Are you guys, you put these guys in charge, you think that Britain will be better off? Britain will be a damn sight worse off, I'll tell you that now. And furthermore, what arrant nonsense these people talk. What sheer blatant hypocrisy. Sovereignty, Britain's national sovereignty. Yes, all of these guys are bootlickers who conduct themselves in the most servile manner, the most bowing and scraping before Donald Trump, of course, all of them lining up, starting with Theresa May, the late unlamented ex-prime minister. She'll probably be by the time this gets put out. All of them scuttling off to Washington, the real centre of British political life. It's not London, it's Washington. Here this man comes here. And by the way, what a cheek. What brazen cheek. I just scratch my head when I see it, you know. All this fuss and nonsense in the States about Russian interference in the US elections and US political life. Oh, this is monstrous. Oh, this requires investigation and so on. Yeah. What about Donald Trump coming here and interfering directly in the political process, even of the election of the Tory party candidate? By the way, the next prime minister of our sovereign British state will be elected by about 150,000 people, members of the Tory party. That's hardly democratic. But all of these people, every single one, including our gracious monarch, the Queen, they're all bowing and scraping before this gangster, this mafioso, who sits in the White House. And he comes here with the intention of carving up as much as he can out of Britain. Oh, yes. Oh, you can offer us the world. What do these Brexiteers say? As long as we are free, at the moment we are free from the shackles of Europe, as Donald Trump puts it, we can trade with the world, my friends. The whole world. The world is bigger than Europe, isn't it? Isn't there lots of markets out there? Yes. Well, you know, one of the most important markets in the world, ask any businessman, he will tell you, is China. China is an important place to do business. The Yanks are telling us straight, Trump is telling us that you cannot trade with China, you cannot trade with, this technological firm, for the new generation of mobile phones. You can't. Why? Because the Americans tell us that we can't. Where's this business of free trade? Where's this business of trading with the rest of the world? No, no, no. What they mean by trading with the rest of the world is only one thing. Trade with the United States of America. And Trump, for once, told the truth. He blurted it out. He was asked a question in a press conference. What about the NHS, Mr. President? And he replied quite sincerely, oh yes, that will be on the table of any trade deal with the United States. You better believe it. He went further. Oh yes, not only the NHS will be on the table, of course, he takes it for granted, but many other things. What other things is he referring to, the great white chief from across the water? Agriculture, of course. You see, Donald Trump himself is a marionette and a puppet of big business. And big business, although he pretends to be against the establishment, he's part of the establishment. Good heavens above. There's a powerful lobby in the States, the pharmaceutical lobby, the big pharmaceutical giants. We've got a very powerful interest in Washington. Oh, and the agricultural lobby, of course. They pay big money to the Republican Party. And big money to Donald Trump. Yes. And what do they want to sell us? Well, they want to sell us, they've been trying for years to get their agricultural goods dumped on the European market. The Europeans are too clever for that. They say, no, 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 no. Now, this nonsense about European regulations, there's too many regulations. Of course, all these gangsters, these Tories, these Brexiteers, are fervent supporters of the free market. Free market economics, you know what that means. Our abolition of all regulations, all controls, yeah? Among others, controls on the working week, controls on health and safety of the workers at work, limits on the profits of the capitalists, minimum wage for workers. All this is absent in the United States, home of the great, home, land of the free. Yes, there's a song, home of the great, land of the free. I won't be pushed around by any bourgeoisie, and it's about time we said that. What do they say? No controls in the States. There was a program on television the other day on Channel 4 about chlorinated chicken, which is proven, by the way. They got chicken which is full of shit. Yes, that's right. Excuse my French. I can't describe it anyhow. Full of excrement, full of filth, which they bathe then in chlorine and other chemicals. which it is proven scientifically does not even clean the meat. Therefore, the percentage of rat shit and mice hairs in our food, which is strictly regulated at the present time, in the European Union, yes, that's true, is not regulated at all in the States. You had pictures taken underground inside one of these chicken factories to show the filth, the shit, the unhygienic conditions. The person who watched this film was an inspector, actually said, when he was asked, would this be acceptable in Britain? He said, no, certainly not. Is it a danger to health? He said, certainly it is. 200 people died last year. Over 200 people died of food poisoning and other salmonella and so on and so forth in the States. In Britain, it was zero. And similar things of this sort. Workers have got no rights in these factories. It's got the highest rate, this industry, the poultry industry, of people having their fingers amputated. I suppose that ends up in the chicken, the Maryland chicken pie, I don't know. But either way, this is a completely retrograde and backward step as far as the British working class and the consumer is concerned. If we accept this Brexit nonsense, we'll fall into the trap of American imperialism the very next day. Of course, the very next day after Trump made these monstrous comments about the NHS, just stupid comments, by the way, because you're not supposed to actually say what you intend. They were all queuing up, weren't they? All the Tory hopefuls, that he's, oh, no, 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 not us, no, no, it won't be on the agenda, we promise, you promise, you bet. I'm telling you now, these denials, because Trump was forced then to backtrack, because they say, they said in private, what the hell are you doing? Letting on our plans, you're making our plans public, you can't do this, this is dangerous, this puts Brexit in danger. I hope that it does, by the way. I sincerely hope that it does. And if any of you believe these denials, which were issued the next day, not at the moment, but the next day, Trump said, oh, no, no, I didn't really mean that. The NHS won't be on the agenda. My friends, it will. You believe these denials from Boris Johnson and these other gangsters? Of course not. You can't trust the Tories further than you can throw them. And to sum up, what is the real intention of Donald Trump? You don't have to look very far. You said it, for goodness sake. Read the man's speeches from the moment that he was a candidate in the election campaign. Donald Trump's program can be expressed very simply: make America great again. And I would add something that he doesn't add: make America great at the expense of the rest of the world. That includes Britain. Oh yes, the special relationship, good heavens above, what world, what fool's paradise are these people living in? The special relationship, I'll tell you what that is. It's a special relationship between the servant and the master. And that's precisely what you saw on your television. All these important people, Boris Johnson, all of them, Farage, all of them, the Queen even, right? Theresa May, bowing and scraping and licking the boots of Donald Trump. That's the special relationship. That's what it means. And if we are foolish enough to go down the Brexiteers' road, then that's how we will end up as yet another state of the United States of America, except that we won't have any decent trade deal with the States. That's nonsense. To begin with, even from a technical point of view, a trade deal with America is going to take years, if not decades, to negotiate. Point number one. Probably Trump won't even be around. Point number two. What is bothering Trump is the trade surplus of Europe with the United States and the trade surplus of China with the United States and Britain's trade surplus. My friends, if you didn't know it, Britain has a larger trade surplus with the States than the rest of Europe put together. And therefore, if we negotiate, if we get to the stage of negotiating a deal with American capital, with these American sharks and gangsters, and incidentally, the pharmaceutical, big pharmaceutical companies, we know, we have evidence, are already making concrete plans to carve up the national health. It's known. It's undeniable. It's there, if you care to investigate the facts. If it ever comes to such a negotiation, what will the aim of Trump and the Americans be? To reduce this surplus and to reduce the deficit of the United States and to turn it into a surplus. In other words, it will not, whatever trade deal is signed with the United States, my friends, it will emphatically not be in the interests of the people of Britain. Not at all. Not in the interests of consumers, not in the interests of workers. And therefore, we should oppose this by every means at our disposal. I think that not enough is made of this. We've accepted for too long this cheap demagogy, this false demagogy, patriotism, get the control of our sovereignty, but what arrant nonsense, you know? It reminds me of something Dr. Johnson said in the 18th century. Patriotism, he said, is the last refuge of a scoundrel. Well, my friends, we've got plenty of scoundrels here sitting in the palace of Westminster, just waiting to carve up the national health, to hand us over, bound hand and foot to the tender mercies of the American capitalists and bankers. Is that the future that we want for our country? Is that the future for the British working class? I tell you that it is not. Therefore, my friends, the next time someone comes knocking on your door, saying, Brexit, Brexit, get control of our country back, patriotism, I will close the door very politely, having said a couple of four-letter words, which basically would mean, you can stick your Brexit and your sovereignty where the monkey sticks his peanuts. Excuse my French, that's all I have to say on the subject.